This is a center punch. You can see here. This center punch is having 90 degree of including angle. The tip point here you can see. This tip point is 90 degree of including angle, and this taper portion. This taper portion is having 14 degree of including angle. And this is knurling portion, this one is turning portion, and this one is this portion. You can see this is chamfering operation, and that is center drill operation. So there are different types of operations are there, and we have to perform different types of operations in lathe machine to make a center punch, taper turning, facing, turning, knurling and center drill. Okay. So let's see how to do this job. ये हमारी मटेरियल रेडी हो रहा है सेंटर पंच के लिए. इसी मटेरियल को काटने के बाद हम लोग लैथ में इसको यूज़ करके सेंटर पंच बना लेंगे. सबसे पहले तो हम लोग जॉब सेट करेंगे इस लैथ मशीन पे. तो ये हमारा वर्क पीस है जो वे अभी कट के लाए हम लोग. तो हम लोग देखते हैं किस तरह से जॉब को सेट किया जाता है लैथ में. ये हमारा चक्की है. विद द हेल्प ऑफ दिस चक्की we can open these three jaws. You can see 1, 2, 3. Three jaws are there. This is three jaw chuck. You can close and open all these jaws at a time with the help of this chuck key. So we have to put this chuck key inside the square hole, inside the square hole of this chuck. I have opened these three jaws. Now it's ready to hold the job. ये हमारा जॉब होल्ड हो गया 22 में. यू कैन सी हियर इट्स हेल्ड इन थ्री जॉ चॉक प्रॉपरली. नाउ वी कैन स्टार्ट द वर्क. लेट्स स्विच ऑन द मशीन फर्स्ट. First, we'll do the facing operation. To do facing, we have to tilt the cutting tool approximately at 45 degree. You can see, approximately 45 degree, we have tilt the cutting tool for facing purpose. facing operation is done. As you can see, we have produced a flat surface which is perpendicular to the job axis. Now we will make a center drill operation. This is a chuck, drill chuck, and I have a drill bit of 5 mm. Actually we have to use a center drill, but this time I don't have that size of center drill bit, that's why I am using this one. By this way we can produce a center drill or center hole to support the job with the help of revolving center, to support the job from the end side with the help of revolving center. We must have to produce a center drill hole. This time I am not having the small size of center drill hole, center drill bit, that's why I am using that 5 mm drill bit.
Light jala do.
Done. Now we'll do the turning operation. For turning purpose, we have to make straight the cutting tool. Then tight it again. Thank you. facing, and turning is over now. Now we will do knurling operation. This is called knurling tool. Here 6 rollers are there. 6 roller, 3 pair, 1 and 2. These two are same in grade. That's why this is one pair, course 1. This is the course in grade. And next, this is the medium in grade. Medium in grade. So this one is second pair. And this is the fine one. Fine in grade, third one. So there are 6 rollers are there. 6 rollers means 3 pair. This is diamond knurling. I am going to set this tool here. See. Now I have to make tight this 1, 2 and 3. These 3 bolts. Now I will show you how to set the knurling tool. With this finished job. So as you can see, 1 and 2, 1 and 2. These 2 rollers are in same grid. So this is one pair. So we have to roll this rod in between of these 2 roller, in between of 1 and 2, this roller. In between of these 2 roller, we have to roll this bar. So as you can see, now make him tight. As you can see, I am going to give support the job from tailstock side, from the side of tailstock. I am using this revolving center. Okay, is going to be great support to doing this job. So now our job is supported by tailstock, okay, for more rigidity. During the knurling operation, we have to give more pressure on job, because we have to going to do non-cutting action, which is non-cutting action. Knurling is a non-cutting operation. Thank you. As you can see, this is knurling operation. Now we are going to do chamfering operation here. Here we will do chamfering operations, and a little amount of little portion we are going to turning also. By means of tilting the cutting tool, we can use this cutting edge for chamfering purpose. You can see. This is called chamfering operation. And this is our knurling. As you can see here, we have finished one side. This side we are going to make taper portion of 7 degree, 14 degrees the including angle, and at the end of that 14 degree including angle, there we are going to a sharp tip point which is going to be 90 degree. So now let's set the job. Now we are going to use the compound slide method for taper turning. You can see here, some graduations are there in degrees. No? We are going to set on 7. This is a 5, and this is 6, and this is a 7. On 7 degree, we are going to set the job. How to set, I will show you. This is the swivel base. In swivel base, you can sweep this compound slide. Sweep this compound slide at the angle of 7 degree. This nut we have to loose. Same nut behind also there. Here also there, you can see, inside also there. These two nut we have to loose. I have loosed the nut, now we can set the degree. This is the reference line. This is the reference line. This is 5, 6, next line is 7. So this line is indicating the 7 degree. Now we have to lock the compound slide again by tightening of this nut. Now itself we will give feet with the help of this compound slide. We will not use the carriage wheel. So you can see how I am making the taper with the help of compound slide method. I am giving feet with the help of this compound slide. पाँच मिनट रुक गया। Now as you can see, our taper turning is finished. Now on the tip we are going to 90 degrees. This is now 14 degree including angle, because we have set on 7 degree, no? That's why 7 plus 7, 14 degree in including angle. But on top of this tip point, we are going to make 90 degree including angle. Now we have to set this swivel base and compound slide on 45 degree. Now we have set the compound slide on 45 degree to make the including angle 90 degree. You can see here, this is a 40 and this is a 45 and this is the reference mark, which is set on 45 degree. So now we can say that our compound slide is set on 45 degree to make the including angle of 90 degree. So let's study it again. You can see here, this is 90 degree. So we have finished our job.
खोलो, हो गया था, खोल दो,
बस 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 बस, हो गया हो गया हो गया, सी दिस इज 14 डिग्री ऑफ इंक्लूडिंग एंगल एंड दिस इज 90 डिग्री ऑफ इंक्लूडिंग एंगल. दैट्स व्हाई दिस इज कॉल्ड सेंटर पांच. सेंटर पांच इज ऑलवेज हैविंग द 90 डिग्री ऑफ इंक्लूडिंग एंगल. सो दिस इज अवर 90 डिग्री ऑफ इंक्लूडिंग एंगल एंड दिस इज द 14 डिग्री ऑफ इंक्लूडिंग एंगल. सो टू टेपर पोर्शन आर देयर, वन एंड टू, टू टेपर पोर्शन, वन एंड टू. दिस इज द स्मॉलर वन. स्मॉलर वन इज हैविंग 90 डिग्री ऑफ टेपर एंगल इंक्लूडिंग एंगल एंड दिस इज 14 डिग्री ऑफ इंक्लूडिंग एंगल. सो दिस इज अवर सेंटर पंच. As you can see,
oh, well, it's okay.
Now job is over. Thank you.